Just ahead, the verdict is in. Former President Donald Trump was found guilty on all counts. Plus, county officials honor Pride Month.
Prince George's County is home to everyone. And today, we're saying that our LGBTQ plus brothers and sisters in Prince George's County are welcome and safe here.
And the pools are open, so we have some safety tips for everyone hopping in the pool this summer.
It's warming up, and what better way to stay cool than with a dip in the pool? But there's a lot of safety factors you've got to keep in mind. I'll walk you through coming up on CTV News.
Those stories and more up next on CTV News.
Good evening. This is CTV News for Friday, May 31st. I'm Katara Jones.
And I'm Gina Barti. Thanks for joining us. Donald Trump becomes the first former president to be convicted of felony crimes yesterday.
After a New York jury found him guilty on 34 counts related to a hush money payment scheme to illegally influence the 2016 election. Trump awaits sentencing in July, where he could face up to 4 years in jail, yet he is still the favorite for the Republican nomination and leading President Joe Biden in some polls. Some believe the conviction will actually encourage Trump voters. County Council Chair Jolene Ivey says she hopes that's not the case.
I'm not sure how it shifts things. Maybe it hardens things, because the people who support Trump, they've always known who he was. He's always been honest with them about that, and they seem to have embraced it. So the ones who support him, I'm not sure that it peels away support. Hopefully people who are a little more open-minded or using their minds will actually see that this man's a convicted felon.
Trump's sentencing is scheduled for July 11th. Meantime, it's officially Pride Month kickoff at the Prince George's County Administration Building. County leaders and local community members came together to pray to raise the Pride flag at the Wayne K. Curry Administration Building in Largo for the first time. The ceremony was led by District 7 Councilwoman Crystal Oriatha, who herself is a member of the LGBTQ community.
But one of the things I realize is so crucial to just allowing our young people to feel like there is space for them to be vocal and out and proud and loud is when they see people in positions of power saying, "We see you, we accept you, and you're welcome."
Maryland Delegate Ashanti Martinez and State Attorney Aisha Brayboy were also in attendance for the historic event.
The second teen arrested in connection with the senior skip day shooting, where five teens were injured in a Greenbelt park, has his first court appearance. At a hearing yesterday, the 14-year-old boy, Bowie High School student, was ordered held without bond. This comes after the first suspect, a 16-year-old boy, was also ordered held without bond. State's Attorney Aisha Brayboy hopes this will send a strong message regarding gun violence in the county.
The message really is really a response from the community, as I am a representative of this community, saying that we will not tolerate this type of behavior. We will not tolerate young people with guns, and certainly we won't tolerate those who choose to use guns to harm others.
Both boys have been charged as adults with multiple counts of the attempted first-degree murder. Several county circuit court judges are vying to fill the vacant seat on Maryland's Supreme Court. According to reports, four Prince George's County circuit judges have applied to join the state's Supreme Court. A seat was left vacant on the state's high court after Justice Michelle Hooten retired last month. The judges have applied include Crystal Alves, Tiffany Anderson, Peter Kiloff, and William Snooty. A commission will interview the applicants and then vote on a candidate. The nominee will then be sent to Governor Wes Moore.
Well, the state is looking to recruit more young dentists to communities that are experiencing a shortage of dental care providers. The Maryland Department of Health launched the Pathways to Bright Futures program in Baltimore this week. The initiative will help address the shortage of dentists in underserved areas and urging young dental professionals to start their careers in those communities. According to the reports, the communities that are seeing a lack of dentists are the Eastern Shore, Western Maryland, and Baltimore. And you're watching CTV News, still to come.
A local foster parent is honored in Montgomery County for her service. That story after the break.
Hate is loud. It gets clicks. It gets attention. Hate, however, is actually quite small. But love. Love is the majority. Filling up something far more important than any feed. Love fills our hearts, our lives, our every day. With understanding, empathy, and compassion. Leaving hate to become what it truly is, a whisper.
Welcome back. Four Bowie State University graduate students pursuing master's degrees in counseling received grant funding. Kenia Siles, Giovanna Jones, Erwina Dixon, and Jada Brown were awarded a $10,000 minority fellowship grant program from the National Board for Certified Counselors. It will be used to support their education and their commitment to underserved and underrepresented communities. A recent Kaiser Family Foundation poll found that 55% of the public see young adult mental health issues as a crisis in the U.S.
The University of Maryland's National Security Research Facility was awarded a $500 million contract from the Department of Defense. This is the largest deal the university has received. The Applied Research Laboratory for Intelligence and Security is one of the 15 university-affiliated research centers within the department and is the only one dedicated to research and development in artificial intelligence, information engineering, and human systems. In other news, a late-night shooting leaves one man dead at around 11 o'clock last night. County police responded to a call for a report of a shooting that occurred on the 6800 block of Hawthorne Street. Upon arrival, police found 40-year-old Anthony Dickens suffering from gunshot wounds. He was pronounced dead at the scene. Police are asking anyone with information regarding this case to call Crime Solvers at 1-866-411-TIPS. A reward of $25,000 is being offered for information leading to an arrest and indictment in this case.
For more than three decades, one woman has given her home, heart, and attention to dozens of Montgomery County foster children. Now, at the age of 88, she is retiring from fostering children. The county held a ceremony today in Rockville to honor her years of dedication. CTV News was there with all the details.
Well, my children were always bringing children home that needed somebody to help them a little bit, and so one day I said, well, maybe I'll just try it, you know, to see if I could do this. And when I started doing it, I loved it.
For 33 years, Emma Patterson has been a foster parent in Montgomery County. The mom of two has welcomed more than 30 children into her home. Today, County Executive Mark Elrich honored the 88-year-old with her decades-long dedication to kids in need.
Most of the children that came to me stayed with me. I was very fortunate that it wasn't a situation like with most foster parents. The children stay with them a little while and then they take them, put them someplace else. Most of the children that came to me stayed with me until they age out of the system.
One of her foster children, who is now an adult, is Michael Brown. He first came to Patterson's home at 5 years
years old. He ultimately left, but ended back in her care at 15.
I was coming from a group home where attention wasn't given to me. Boundaries wasn't given to me. So she put in structure and foundation for me, put me back in school, got my grades together, played football, went to school for a little while, and actually now work for Montgomery County Government, DOT. So it's been a blessing. She's been a pillar of my success. I thank her for everything.
With her final foster child set to graduate from high school this year, she is set to retire. Patterson has some important advice for anyone looking to foster a child.
And if you're not doing it for the right reasons, don't do it because you think you're going to make money or anything like that. If you do it, you do it because it's something you want to do from your heart, that you truly feel that you can love these children, you know. And if you don't feel that you can love them and take care of them like they're your own children, don't do it.
Peter and Meredith Sloan were also recognized by the county as Foster Parents of the Year.
A Prince George's County man was cited by police after TSA officers intercepted a loaded firearm among the man's carry-on items at Reagan National Airport on Thursday. The Capitol Heights resident told officials he forgot that he had the gun with him. Airport Authority police seized the weapon that was loaded with 23 bullets, including one in the chamber, and issued the man a citation. Now, guns are not permitted through the security checkpoint, and travelers can face fines reaching a maximum of $15,000.
Well, we have some good news for Maryland drivers as the state's gas tax is set to decrease slightly in July. The rate is scheduled to decrease by 9/10 of a penny starting July 1st, and it is the third gas tax decrease since 2013. The new gas tax will be set at 46.10 cents per gallon for gasoline and 47.75 cents per gallon for diesel fuel. Although the decrease appears to be small, it could have a larger impact on the state's transportation trust fund budget, which is already dealing with a backlog of highway transit projects.
Rotum.
ASARotum.
Sheen Talante.
SCINTILLANTE.
Mira Balanus.
MYROBALANUS.
Sinif.
SCINIPH.
And a standing ovation for Bruhat.
Well, that amazing speller is 12-year-old Bruhat Soma of Tampa, Florida. Last night, he was crowned the winner of the 96th Scripps National Spelling Bee. After spelling 29 words correctly in a row in 90 seconds during a spell-off with his competitor, the word that clinched his victory was abseil, spelled A-B-S-E-I-L. Hey, I almost got that. And it means rappelling down from a mountain using rope.
I'm really excited. Like, it's been my goal for this past year to win. And I've been working really hard, so I just like put a lot of time to spelling, and then now I'm really happy that I won. Like, I really can't describe it. Like, I'm still shaking.
As the champion, Soma will receive a trophy and more than $50,000 in cash and prizes. Good for him. Yeah, abseil, huh?
I couldn't do it.
I know.
Still to come, the Beltway Barbecue Showdown is back.
We'll have all the details after the break. Don't go away.
To sit with a dog on a glorious day, it's like heaven. Where doing nothing isn't boring, it's peaceful. When the right dog finds the right human, it's as if it always was and always will be. Protect each other, love each other, teach each other. More importantly, they never let the other down.
I'm Christopher Holton. I'm very active. It was a Saturday morning. Normally, I go for my normal walk.
With no warning, Chris suffered a near fatal heart attack. But thankfully, Brian Buckley, a bystander, saw him collapse and rushed to help.
He did this big gasp for air and then just stopped. It's like I went into autopilot. It's like all that training I did back in the day around CPR just magically came out of nowhere.
Because of the CPR training that Brian received, Chris did make it and didn't die on the trail that day. CPR training provided by the American Heart Association.
Looking at your hands, these two hands could save a life.
Being a father, you want to be around. You want to be around for your kids.
Heart disease is America's number one killer. To learn more about how the American Heart Association helps save lives, go to helpheart.org.
Well, this Sunday is the 14th edition of the Beltway Barbecue Showdown. The contest highlights the art of barbecuing in the county as competitors compete for a spot in the Kansas City American Royal Barbecue Competition.
There will also be cooking demonstrations, crafts, and goods for sale, even a truck and car show. Here to talk a little bit about it is about the showdown is Jennifer Munoz with the Prince George's Parks and Recreation. Welcome to our show.
Thank you for having me.
So first, talk a little bit about what is the Beltway Barbecue Showdown.
Well, the Beltway Barbecue Showdown is a competition of 19 different teams competing for a spot to have the best barbecue. But not only that, we have stuff for kids and adults from the car show, entertainment, live entertainment. It's really something for the whole entire family.
So not only do you have all those things going on at the barbecue competition, people can walk around and taste the barbecue as well, I hope.
Of course, yeah. So we will have barbecue vendors. The people competing, they won't be selling their barbecue, but there will be opportunities if you're there and you're one of the lucky ones to have a little taste of what they have to offer. But we'll have plenty of barbecue for sale there.
Terrific.
And who is this event for?
This event is really for the families and people of all ages, both young and young at heart. We really have something for everyone to enjoy this weekend.
Now, are you guys seeing, is there a particular kind of barbecue that usually shows up here in the county? I know that they have the Memphis-style barbecue, and they even have the North Carolina-style barbecue. What kind of barbecue do you guys usually see here in the county?
So for this competition, it's in particular Kansas City-style barbecue. So if you're a fan of Kansas City barbecue, I know I don't have a preference, but if you are, this will be the place to go.
That's interesting. I've never heard of Kansas City barbecue.
I didn't know that was a thing. Yeah.
You know, there's Kansas City, there's Texas, you mentioned the Carolinas, so each city has their own flavor and twist to barbecue. But we're excited to bring a little bit of that here to Prince George's County.
And tell us when and where will this take place?
This will be Sunday at the Showplace Arena in Upper Marlboro from 12 noon to 6 p.m.
So go back a little bit for me. What are we actually judging the competitors on?
So we're judging the competitors on the quality of food, the taste, and just their overall, what they're presenting for us. So we have several different judges there who are the experts, and we'll be able to judge who has the best barbecue.
And 14 years, long time to have this type of competition. Why bring it back to the county every year?
You know, it's something that the community loves, and it brings everyone of all walks of life. And, you know, we love food here in Prince George's County. We love live entertainment. So we bring it back because the community asked for us to bring it back. It's such a good event.
Now, do the people attending the competition actually get to vote on some of the barbecues as they go around, or no, it's just the judges that are?
The judges are the experts, but of course, like I mentioned, there will be opportunities here and there to at least taste it.
Now, is this a rain or shine event? Because I heard Sunday we're expecting a little rain.
As of right now, rain or shine, so come out.
Great, great. And where can people find more information about it?
You can visit us at our website at pgparks.com.
Terrific. Thank you so much for
joining us.
Well, the 14th Beltway Barbecue Showdown takes place this Sunday from noon until 6 p.m. at the Showplace Arena. For more information, you can call 301-952-7900. And don't go away, Simon Bugs will be joining us with Friday Sports Page.
NFL sports fans are coming up on your Friday sports page. Former UMD quarterback Talia Tagovailoa continues to try to live out his dream of playing professional football. I'll have more on the story in a minute. Stay right there.
Another teenager, victim to fake pills. That smells like big crime that needs to be stopped. Before buying pills online, think about this. Should buying prescription pills be this easy?
Yeah, bro, I'm picking up. Same guy. I bet. Got you five.
Think these pills are tested and safe? Think they're the same ones you get from a doctor? You know they're not. Did you know that fake prescription pills may contain fentanyl? And an amount small enough to fit on the tip of a pencil can be lethal. Listen. Before buying pills from social media, think again. Learn more at McGruffPSA.org and go for real.
Plastic is flooding our planet, polluting our land, air, and water, hurting wildlife and destroying delicate ecosystems. Once it's in our environment, it's here to stay. Our planet isn't single use, and our plastic shouldn't be either. We can stop this by changing how plastic is made, used, and recycled. Working with communities, governments, and industries, and building a better system from the ground up. It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel like it's a beautiful day. To let it get away. A clean planet is possible. Let's build it together. WWF.earth/plastics.
Welcome back. If you're like some people, you are counting down the days till last weekend, which many consider the start of summer, and the day pools open across most of the state.
But before we dive in, we have to make sure that we're keeping in mind the most important factor, safety. CTV's Mariah Gillad is bringing us all we need to know from one of our great county pools.
We all want to be having fun this summer, but the most important thing is to stay safe, especially when it comes to being in the water. So PG Parks is going to give us the rundown on how to do just that.
There are risks around the water. Drowning is the number one leading cause of death by injury for children ages 1 to 4, and the second leading cause for children 5 to 14. So there are risks along with the pools and water, and we want people to be educated about the importance of being safe around the water.
The Parks Department says when it comes to swimmer safety, you should keep it smart and simple.
We recommend not to use the floaties, that the life jacket is the best way to protect as far as things, wearable items. But most importantly is the education and getting your kids into swim lessons so that they're comfortable, and also that the adults are in swim lessons, because we have a population that the adults are not comfortable around the water. So it's also important to learn if you're an adult that does not know how to swim. You're never too old. We have lessons for all age groups. It doesn't matter your age. You know, being able to swim is a life skill, and it's an awesome one to have. Even our seniors enjoy some of our water aerobics and fitness classes. And so just being safe in the water and knowing how to swim is a great way to get your exercise at any age.
Summer classes are still available with the Parks Department, and they've even added more spots to make sure everyone can get their aquatic education. But even if you think you're a strong swimmer, there's another factor to keep in mind.
Only swim in locations that have lifeguards to make sure that you have that additional layer of protection. It only takes a moment to drown, and it doesn't matter the depth of the water. So it's important to be safe whether you're in deep water or if you're also in shallow water, that we're using those same safety skills.
And if you ever find yourself or another person in a dangerous or scary situation in the water, calling out for help is your first step.
Those lifeguards are trained to be able to rescue, and so you yourself as a participant should not go and try to rescue, but you should warn the lifeguard in the area to help them start that process.
And once you have all these safety tips down, the next step is clear.
Come out and have a great time with us. Department of Parks and Recreation has 14 pools across the county, indoors and outdoors. And it's a wonderful opportunity to enjoy the water, but just let's be safe when we're doing it.
For more information on all the great pools in the county, you can visit pgparks.com. And don't forget that sunscreen this summer. From Glendale, Mariah Jalad, CTV News.
Thanks, Mariah. Well, that definitely got me excited to take a dip this weekend.
And once again, that website is pgparks.com.
What's up, everybody? Get pumped because it's time for your Friday Sports Page. We begin with some football news. Former UMD quarterback Talia Tungavailoa's NFL dreams haven't panned out so far, unfortunately. After not hearing his name get called during the NFL draft last month, Tungavailoa got invited to both the Seattle Seahawks and Arizona Cardinals rookie minicamps, but he didn't make the roster for either squad. Tungavailoa now appears to be headed up north as he is close to signing a deal with the Hamilton Tiger Cats of the Canadian Football League. Tungavailoa will definitely add some talent to the Tiger Cats roster, as during his time as a Terp, he passed for over 11,000 yards, which ranks first all-time in Big Ten history. The Hawaii native also led the conference in completions, attempts, yards, and passing TDs in his final season. Moving on to the world of baseball, if you or anyone you know loves to play baseball, then you should definitely stop by the On Deck Batting Cage. Located in Capitol Heights, the On Deck Batting Cage is one of the first batting cages to open in Prince George's County. The cage has baseball bats, baseballs, and pitching machines. I caught up with the owner, Andre Hockaday, and he touched on what his membership options were for anyone that is looking to come to his cage.
So the memberships that we have, they are $129 per month, and you can use, there's two different options. The first option is a $129 per, they're both $129. The first option is 10 visits that last 1 year. So that comes out to be like $12.90 per visit. And then the second option is $129 unlimited visits per month. So that'd be $129 per month. And you can come as many times as you want for 1 hour visits.
The On Deck Batting Cage is located at 1420 Ritchie Marlboro Road in Unit B2. Now to the Major Leagues, the Washington Nationals will take the diamond tonight against the Cleveland Guardians. The game begins at 7:10. And wrapping up sports, good news basketball fans, as the NBA Finals teams are set as the Dallas Mavericks will take on the Boston Celtics. I, for one, cannot wait to see how these teams perform on the big stage. The NBA Finals will begin in Boston on June 6th. And that wraps up your Friday Sports Page. Simon Bugs, CTV Sports.
Thanks, Simon. Let's get a look at our weekend forecast. Tonight, clear skies with a low of 55. Saturday, not a cloud in the sky to put a damper on an outdoor plans, with a high of 82 and a low of 64.
And guess what, you guys? Sunday, you're going to have to grab those rain boots and umbrellas again. There's a chance of showers and thunderstorms all day, but the temps will reach a high of 80 and fall to about 63 degrees. Monday, the sun comes back, and with the work week, of course, with high of 82 and a low of 64. And now let's get a quick check of our community calendar. Celebrate Pride Month at the Mount Pelier House Museum with the Rainbow Tea. Indulge in scones, finger sandwiches, pastries, and your choice of two quality loose leaf teas, all served on pretty china.
It takes place June 8th from 2 until 4 in the afternoon, and you must RSVP by June 4th. For more information to RSVP, call 301-377-7817. And that wraps up CTV News for now. I'm Katara Jones.
And I'm Gina Barti. Join us again on Monday for your local news. Have a great weekend. Good night.